season.
Boston. It comes, and he lost the football. Mariota had it jarred loose.
A place like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from it. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
So the offense avoids disaster, keeps possession. Now it's second down. Here's the first carry now for Todd Gurley. And he'll take this up only to about his 18-yard line. They'll get a couple yards back, but not more than that. They'll be left with 12 yards to go on third down. For them now, it's fourth down.
It's a great job by this secondary. When I watch them, they remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on third down to bring up fourth. And take it right on the 30. 49-yard punt, 5 on the return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And the first drive, 3 and out. Second possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop. Throwing to start the drive. Warner. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course.
It's always tough trying to keep your guy upright when he's trying to throw the football. When you're dealing with those big, bad guys on the defensive front, it's even tougher. And this time, those guys on the opposite side won the battle, getting to the quarterback and knocking him into an incompletion.
Now with the play clock about to expire, we get a whistle and a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Second down now after the incompletion. To throw again, Warner. And the hookup here to Allen Robinson. He's at the 30. 10. Touchdown, Chicago! Allen Robinson, 64 yards. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead.
I think if you pulled defensive backs, they would say the corner route, take that out, make it illegal, because that is so hard to recognize and so hard to adjust, because your first move is to not get beat in the middle of the field. And that's how they move you first before they break off to the corner.
But then as the wide receiver, great job. It's tough to turn those upfield and go, but he did a great job with it there.
Really good balance, really good body control, and how about the end result? A touchdown.
And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. And now back out comes the offense. This is their third drive. Right now, maybe not about points, just about getting something. They haven't gotten a first down yet in this game.
It's a mental barrier you don't think about until you go a couple of drives without getting a first down. Then all of a sudden it looms big. It gets harder and harder to actually attain that first down.
In motion, the tight end Reed. First and 10, here's Mariota. And he's gonna go down. Back at his own 5-yard line, it's a sack. Mario Addison in there to bury him for a loss of 11. Now on second down, this is Gurley. And he'll go down for a loss inside his own 5 at the 4. He lost 2 there, and it's third down.
What do you think, Brandon? I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in these first few drives. They're not just holding the line because they're doing their job, and they're doing more than that, aren't they? They get a nice push into the offensive backfield.
And a great example right there for the loss on the tackle. They'll get a couple of yards on the keeper, but it's going to lead to a fourth down.
Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you're expected to break a little bit bigger than this one, because when you run him on short gains, your risk reward and him taking hits, I'm not sure that's the payoff they were looking for.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. It's fielded at the 45. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. It's the hometown guys with a football here to begin this second quarter of play as they take over following the punt with a first and 10. Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. A first down carry by Elliott. And he'll get a little over two, maybe a full three down to the 32-yard line.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it. Because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
To throw on second down, Warner. Oh, the ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowl safety, Cam Chancellor.
God, Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball, and I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
Start the drive with Gurley. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. Maybe a little sign of life here offensively, Charles. They get their first down. They didn't have any in quarter number one.
And I think what we're seeing is great evidence of good scouting by both teams. Right? Understand what they like to do. Their best players try and take those away early. So now we're seeing some adjustments, and they end up getting their first down.
Second down, caught on the right side, Reed. That one good for the completion percentage, but no gain. It'll be third down.
And that's when it's fun to play defense, when you're able to diagnose a play right from the beginning, get all your guys to the football, and still the play. That's when you have a lot of fun playing on that side of the ball.
On third down, Mariota. He's got Curse, and he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. That goes for a gain of 31.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield, but when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosion.
And it's caught. Touchdown. Jordan Reed, a 12-yard touchdown grab. And his guys are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Yeah, he is a reliable target. They like to get him involved. They got him involved there for the score.
And they should. He's a very good player. Remember, they can use him in certain positions, so many different spots, and he usually comes through for them.
Play clock winding down. Anderson. His throw incomplete. And that is one, no doubt, that may come back to haunt them, because the PAT tied it. They didn't need to go for two.
I keep searching for an explanation. I know it's quick right here. I think I can search for the next year and not come up with anything that absolutely works. Kick the point, man. Kick the point. I don't get it.
Now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. A minute 57 to go in this first half. Back to Tennessee after this. Off the play fake. Warner. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. 23 yards on the play. A handoff left, Elliott. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs. And let's face it, they know how to finish plays, too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
It's complete here to T.Y. Hilton. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. On first and 10. Warner, they'll set up the screen to Elliott, and he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. The first down screen pass, good for 5.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Oh, it's a screen pass, that's complete. 7 yards on the pickup there, and now they've got it first and goal. Well, this is how you shake the thoughts of that interception on the last drive. You come out and start this one 4-for-4.
And watching him throw it around with that type of confidence reminds me of a guy I played with way back when and told me, I don't care if I throw 10 interceptions in a row, I'm going to stay.
And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. Ezekiel Elliott, a 9-yard touchdown run. And his guys are going to add on to their lead. And it's up. It's good. Our score, 14-6. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he's all the way up across the 40 and down at the 42-yard line. Great return.
At some point, we're going to get it through our heads. Special teams, special teams, special teams. The spark that often wins games.
They go play action here on first down. And they get to Mariota here as he's dropped on the sack. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. As it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. Second down, Mariota. That'll be incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock. The Pro Bowler DeAndre Hopkins, the intended receiver, and it's third down. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. Third and long here for Mariota. Jordan Reed has it. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. And now a long one for Matt Bryant. He's hit from 62 in his career, but that was all the way back in 2006. This will be from 56 yards out. A final shot before break. So we have reached halftime here in what's an 8-point game. As we send you down to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando, where we find our man Larry Ridley with our halftime report. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This will be taken in at the 1. And a nice This return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you turn that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
See if they do just that. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Looking to throw on second down. Warner. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Throwing on third and long. Warner. And that one drops incomplete as he got popped as he was throwing it.
Granted, it looked like he had his hands on it for a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Yeah, nice job to force the incompletion. On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. This is brought in at the 21. It looked like he might beat that last man. He doesn't, though, but it goes as a 32-yard return. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over with a first and 10 on the short side of the field. And the wideout in motion. Time to establish the run game here. Gurley. And a big hit there as he runs into a brick wall. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized. 20. It's caught over the middle. Hoover. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. A really nice gain of 25 yards. The tight end changing his position. On first down, it's Gurley. And he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Second down following the run. Another carry now for Gurley. And he'll take it into the end zone for a touchdown. Todd Gurley, a 15-yard touchdown run. And his guy's now just a 2-point conversion away from tying us up. Throwing, Mariota. Goes right side. And he's got it. So they went ahead and went for two to tie the game, and it works out. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Six-time Pro Bowler Randy Moss, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. It's a gain of 5, and just like that, it's third down.
I think the best offenses love to give the ball to their running backs in open space because they have the ability to make people miss, and they also have the ability to run over people. And if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
Well, we saw him shed a nice tackle on that play.
I remember growing up playing basketball, my coaches always talked about communicating.
communicating on defense, making sure you talk on defense, know where your screens are, know where the cuts are coming from, who has who. Well, guess what? It's the same thing in football. Even though there's more noise out there, you can hear all the screams of screen, screen. This defense, the bench, everyone let them know what the play was, and that's why they're able to react and knock the ball away.
And he has the first down yardage before they bring him down right at the 45.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen, where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together.
Oh, Elliott going to be hit. He coughs it up. Loose football. And this will be scooped up by the defense. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But, hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big-time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
They'll start out on the ground with Gurley. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. No gain on the play there. Second down. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it's the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
And he motions the wide receiver. Again, they run with Gurley. And some room to roam now. 31 yards there and a first down.
I love football lingo and the evolution of it all. Nickel defense makes sense, right? Five defensive backs. But then you go to six. What are you going to call that? They call it a
double
dime. A dime, which is just very simple for them. The math doesn't add up. But I know one thing. Offenses love to run against dime defenses. Typically, the bigger guys have an advantage against the smaller defensive backs when they're blocking downfield.
Yeah, we saw that advantage right there. The wide receiver moving to a new spot. From the pistol, it's Gurley. He winds up getting only a couple there, down to the 29.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, four plays in this drive, all four on the ground. Back now in Nashville. This a big play for both sides. What will we see here? Third and four. And the wideout in motion. Mariota from the gun on third down. Complete outright to Kurz. And he gets into the end zone for the touchdown. Jermaine Kurz, 29 yards. And his guys are going to take the lead.
Everybody likes to see the long ball thrown, but when you throw it underneath and you see someone catch the ball, secure it, make their moves, and then turn it into bigger plays, that's a lot of fun to watch as well.
Here's Boscher to kick it away. It's a short kick, taken at the 15. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Well, they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And the trend continues here in the fourth like it was in the first, second, and third. He's had nowhere to run.
And you're probably thinking to yourself, why do they keep feeding him the football? Well, they trust him first and foremost. They do believe that over time he might actually pop one of these runs. The bottom line is he takes care of the ball well for them, so they'll keep handing it to him.
12 yards there as they move the chains. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
On first down, Warner. Caught left side. taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 10 more there and another first down.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
The offense certainly looking to score some points, but they also need ball security here late as we get down to the final moments of this one. Pressure, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back right around the 44. Michael Kendricks not dropping into coverage. He comes on the blitz and takes him down for a loss of 9. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Off play action. Warner. And he took the contact as he was throwing it. And the ball drops incomplete.
Well, any caused incompletion is good for a defense. But when you add to it that you get a little hit on the quarterback, knock him to the ground, make him think a little bit, hopefully knock him off his game, especially in a game of this magnitude, this tight in the fourth quarter, got to feel pretty good as a defense.
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off at the 24. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. Now this offense about ready to take over again. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. And he motions the wide receiver. They'll stick to the ground game with Gurley. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he'll go out of bounds across the 35-yard line. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
First seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. The wide receiver moving to a new spot. Now Gurley, handoff left. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Now defensively here, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Today. It's Gurley. Gurley's got the first down and end zone. Past the 20. And touchdown. Todd Gurley. His second touchdown.